Many strange things happened in the 1980s. For one small town in the Midwest, a sequence of mysterious happenings turned everything upside down. The Netflix series Stranger Things started out as a modest love letter to 80s pop culture, and came to be one of the most popular original series that the streaming service has to offer. I am a huge fan of this series because the characters and storylines are interesting and entertaining, even though they do have some imperfections. In this video, I will give you a brief description of the first season as well as my evaluations. Stranger Things is a science fiction slash horror series that first premiered in 2016. The story begins during the year 1983 in the fictional small town of Hawkins, Indiana, and follows preteen boys Mike, played by Finn Wolfhard, Dustin, played by Gaten Matarazzo, and Lucas, played by Caleb McLaughlin, as they investigate the disappearance of their friend Will, played by Noah Schnapp, with help from their new friend Eleven, played by Millie Bobby Brown, a preteen girl with telekinetic powers and a mysterious backstory. Other characters include Mike's older sister Nancy, played by Natalia Dyer, her boyfriend Steve, played by Joe Kerri, Will's older brother Jonathan, played by Charlie Heaton, as well as Will and Jonathan's mother Joyce, played by Winona Ryder, and the Hawkins Chief of Police, Jim Hopper, played by David Harbour. Now that you have a basic understanding of the characters and plot, I will now share some of my opinions on the first season as a whole. Part of what makes Stranger Things unique is how it draws inspiration from many different films from the 1980s in order to create something that feels somewhat familiar but entirely new at the same time. Therefore, whether or not you are a die-hard fanatic of pop culture from this decade, extensive knowledge is not required in order to enjoy Stranger Things, as the series can still stand on its own two feet without having to rely too heavily on references from this time period. Even still, the show doesn't come without its flaws. For example, many episodes of the series utilize flashing lights or patterns to recall memories of certain horror movies from the 80s, but the frequent use of this effect could turn off some modern viewers who may be photosensitive. Another example of the series' shortcomings comes from the performances of the younger actors, as they can fall short when it comes to convincing the audience that their characters are completely emotionally invested in their situations. One particular scene that comes to mind is when Mike is showing Eleven around his house when she first arrives. Although this is meant to be an homage to films like E.T. the Extraterrestrial, the ways that actor Finn Wolfhard delivers his lines feel somewhat stilted and inauthentic. This was a brief summary of the first season of Stranger Things, as well as some of my personal thoughts about the series. Despite some of its flaws, I still really love this show because of just how captivating it is. Therefore, I hope you'll join in on the adventure of watching Stranger Things to get caught up in all the 80s nostalgia. Don't forget to bring some friends along, just in case you may find yourself getting trapped in the Upside Down.